The way stress affects horses and the development of ulcers is not fully understood, but we know that there are some definite consequences of elevated cortisol, the stress hormone in the horse. Horses are susceptible to developing gastric ulcers for a couple different reasons. One is their anatomy. Unfortunately for the horse, the lining of the esophagus extends down into the stomach. And so horses can get heartburn and GERD in their stomach, similar to how people get reflux disease. The other reasons are how we manage horses. So when horses do get stressed, they tend to eat differently. And so the change in their feeding patterns then predisposes again that stomach to getting acid where it's not supposed to within the stomach. In the horse, because of the two different types of lining in their stomach, they get ulcers in both different places, and they happen for various, very different reasons. The first one we'll talk about is equine squamous gastric disease. That's the tissue that lines the top of the stomach. And so that's very sensitive to acid. It has really no inherent protection from the acid. And so when acid gets up there in that part of the stomach, it will burn it and create an ulcer. The second type are the ulcers that develop in the true stomach lining, or what we call glandular mucosa. So that would be equine glandular gastric disease when we see those ulcers. Clinical signs we see in horses related to gastric ulcers is a wide range. The ones that are most supported in the literature are gonna be behavioral changes as well as performance changes. And then we can see some medical conditions like failure to gain weight or loss of weight, potentially poor hair coats, and then eating and drinking differences. The gold standard for diagnosing ulcers would be using a gastroscopy, where we pass a gastroscope, which is a long tube with a light and a camera on the end, down through the horse's nose. They swallow it all the way into the stomach so we can see it live. And the thing that the advantage that that gives us is that we can see the severity of the disease and the location. With squamous disease, in the vast majority of cases, up to a month of treatment is going to be all that horse needs. From a glandular disease standpoint, we see more of a variation between the response in horses. And so in some horses, it can be relatively quick, within a month. Some horses, it might take several months to get the glandular disease under control. Looking at the two different locations and the difference in the physiology of that tissue and why the lesions occur in the first place, we really can't just say if we think your horse has ulcers, this is what we should treat it, because they're different and we may spend a lot of money and not effectively manage the horse. So again, that goes back to doing gastroscopy to tell us exactly where the lesions are. And they might be in both places, or they might just be in one or the other. And knowing that will help us direct the best treatment for that individual horse. I'm Dr. Hoyt Cheramie, and together with your veterinarian, we can master equine health.